Lord, we come before you acknowledging you are the God of all creation. We thank you for the renewal of life we witness as your creation awakens from winter's rest and all around us seems fresh and new. We gather tonight to lift our hearts and our voices to you in praise, thankful that we can freely express our love and our worship to you in this place. We humbly ask that your favor would ever be on us, that your spirit would ever dwell in us, that your power would ever be our strength. We pray that all that is sung and all that is said during this time we spend together tonight will be solely for your honor and for your glory, and that it would be a time of renewal and reawakening for your people. Amen.
Good evening. Welcome, all of you here in the sanctuary and those who are watching the live stream. I believe we are in for a treat this evening. We are, Oshawa Temple is very pleased to have the opportunity to host Canadian Staff Songsters under the leadership of the Executive Officer, Lieutenant Colonel John Murray, and the Director, Major Len Ballantine. Please join with me as we give them a warm welcome.
Well, good evening, friends, those who are gathered here and also watching online. It's a joy to welcome you into this sanctuary tonight and to be able to share in worship. This is about coming together into God's presence, to listen, to share, and to worship God. And that's what we hope that as we sing, as you listen, that you will be encouraged, that you will come into God's presence. This morning, as we were watching, I'm sure many of us in this room, the coronation, and as we saw those beautiful pictures and those moments, the majesty of that time together in that beautiful abbey, simply reminded of the importance of Scripture and how it weds and embeds everything together. And then the music in those moments that just transcend us into the presence of God. And that would be our prayer this evening, as we share tonight in this place and tomorrow morning as again we share in worship, that you might, your hearts might be filled and stirred and encouraged, and you might go out hopeful from these moments together. This night, I'm going to invite those who are able in the sanctuary here to join, and we're going to sing our opening song. Everybody's going to join in as a choir, so I would invite you to stand. We're marching on, and we're going to sing three verses straight through with an introduction from our pianist. Thank you.
Thank you.
night, worshiping and praising God. Please be seated.
Save me, Lord. Somewhere on the lonely stretches of the internet, you can find a version of that sung from Hallelujah Point in Vancouver. In the pouring rain. I was told to expect a little drizzle, and I have never been rained on with such prolific drops in my entire life. We had a planned stop at Hallelujah Point, which is the starting of the work of the Salvation Army in that area of Canada. We planned to stop there. We didn't plan on having torrential rain. And we were all dressed in our little black outfits with a hoodie on. And I sent the group off the bus ahead of us, and Heather and I kind of blazed along in the rain. And when I got there, they looked like drowned cats. It was just, was really pathetic. So I started to sing that song. And they joined in. And if you went on the internet, you could probably find that. It's very humorous. All the while we were suffering, Colonel John ran around with a live camera, broadcasting to the entire world our misfortune. And they rallied to the man, to the girl, to the person. They had wonderful, splendiferous smiles to offer. Who would have thought that they were singing in such dire conditions? So that was a nice recovery. Thank you for this performance tonight. Appreciate that. We're going to continue with a combination of two spirituals, Old Time Jericho. So you might imagine what they are, Old Time Religion and Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. We're going to take you to the Deep South now, and we're going to sort of take you into an old-time gospel meeting with the help of our soloist, Ian Cooper. Would you like to welcome him, please?
Sorry, sorry, praise God.
children of Israel. How God blessed the nation. How God won the day.
Canadian Staff Songsters were formed in 2016 under the leadership of Major Len Ballantine. But of course, if you go back in our history, the CSS, the first CSS, was actually formed in 1916. And it existed for a very short time. Of course, if you think back historically, we're in the middle of World War I. So the Army established the Canadian Staff Songsters, and then because of the Great War, of course, they had to close it down. Fast forward 100 years, 2016, we established this iteration of the Canadian Staff Songsters. And over the last 6 years, we had, of course, a little hiccup with the pandemic and COVID, as we all did. But the group continued to rehearse, believe it or not, weekly on Zoom during COVID. Len and Kathy and the team kept everything going. But one of the things that we've been able to do during that period of time is we've been able to visit different places across the territory, as well as the United States. We've had the joy of not only sharing right across the province of Ontario, and thank you for this invitation this weekend. It's the second time in the 6 years that we've been to Oshawa, and I'm gonna invite our current CSS members from Oshawa, if you could stand, please, to be recognized. There we go. And I heard that was a huge shout out for Steve Cooper back there, right, Steve? After that beautiful presentation moments ago. But I know there are a couple other people who have a long association, Louise and Alexandria, correct? Stand up and be recognized. And thank you to the Corps for supporting this staff section as you do. Because we do recognize when we go away on a ministry weekend, as we try to do once a month, that it does take away from the core. So thank you for allowing these folks to step out of the sections and leadership and come and minister and share across the province. We've also had the joy of worshiping in Bermuda. We marched in the Calgary Stampede and took in the Stampede weekend one year. And we were down in Chicago as well and had a wonderful time there. Most recently though, over Easter weekend, we flew out on Monday, Thursday to the British Columbia Division, and we went to Victoria. We shared in ministry Good Friday at Victoria Citadel, over the weekend at Cascade Community Church, Easter Sunday at Caribou Hill Temple, and you heard of our exploits as well already at Hallelujah Point. Very memorable, and one of the beautiful moments as well was sharing at Buchanan Lodge, the Salvation Army's long-term care home in Burnaby, Easter Sunday afternoon. Of course, the message of Easter is continuous, isn't it? It's not just about Good Friday and Easter Sunday. We celebrate that resurrection. That is what our faith is based on. And I'm going to invite you to listen now as the staff songsters share Green Hill, and they could not.
Thank you.
Mixed choirs are a little different from same-sex choirs. You know, community choirs, men's glee clubs, barbershop quartets, that kind of. This is a very different thing. When you have men and women together, it's a little competitive. You know, when we're doing rehearsals, the women always want to show off and say, guys, you listen to us, we're going to sing this for you, and you imitate us, that sort of thing. That's what happens in rehearsal. And sometimes, when we're really fortunate, the men will say, okay, we've got the tune here, so you listen to us, we'll take care of it, and you come in when we're done. So there's always that dynamic of competitiveness within a mixed group such as this. And having had the taste of a wonderfully powerful bass solo earlier on in the program, we knew that we had to put the ladies up after that in order to just keep everything balanced. So with the use of three wonderful spirituals and then gospel music, you know, some of my favorite music types in the world, out of this collection of wonderful spiritual songs, we're going to sing three of them, and we're going to ask all of the first sopranos to sing this solo, as one, as it were. So it's not really a solo, but it is a solo, because all of them are singing the same part, if you know what I mean. So they're going to share the glory, whereas Ian was able to sort of absorb all of the glory for himself. Our first sopranos are going to sing Let It Shine, and it features three spirituals, and it kind of gets down to the roots of what we believe, and the spirit of our worship, and the spirit of our convictions. I think you'll enjoy it. Let It Shine.
Thank you. pasango.
Ay, 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 ay,
to Jesus. Now for this one, you got to do a little two-step. Len Ballantine loves this. So you go forward and backward, and forward and backward, and forward and back. And you just kind of move your hips, just like General Booth would do. Oh yes, John Murray. Acholi, Jesu Maro, which means Jesus loves. So we are going to sing Jesu Mara. And there's a part, Alleluia, which means Hallelujah. Oh, which means Oh. And you just turn to your neighbor. You give them high ten. Okay? Don't worry about COVID. You can use hand sanitizer afterwards. Jesu Mara. Jesu Mara. Observation I've made about our culture is that we always seem to want more. And so what I want you to do is think for a moment of things that you already have and just turn to your neighbor, tell them three things that you're really grateful for today. Tell your neighbor.
I'm grateful for your piano playing and for your bass playing.
The theme of this weekend is all things new. And so a new idea for us this evening is, rather than wanting more and more and more, what if we were just grateful for what we had? What if we believe that God is enough, that we are enough, that we have enough, that God is more than enough? We're gonna sing a song, I Shall Not Want.
Will you be my light when I cannot see? When I can't take another step, Lord, would you carry me? When I've lost my fight, will you be my strength? Will you set me a table in the presence of my enemies? Shall not want. Oh, my soul's got a shepherd in the valley, and I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want. 'Cause my cup's running over, and I shall not want. I will lift my eyes to where my help comes from. Shadow, 'cause I've seen the sun. No, I will not stop when the way gets hard. 'Cause the green only grows in the valley, and that's where you are. I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want. Oh, my soul's got a shepherd in the valley, and I shall not.
I got goodness and I got mercy. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I got goodness and I got mercy. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. The good shepherd waters. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. He anoints me with his oil. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Now my cup is running over.
from my eyes, and I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want. I'll be home in His presence forever, and I shall not want.
Lord Jesus Christ, thank You that You are home for us. And God, You are everything we need. And God, if our hearts were on the outside this evening and You would see all of the questions that we have, the anxiety we have, the concerns we have, and God, we believe that You are enough. And we thank You that we are not alone. We are here together and we are united by You. And so we trust You as our Father, our beautiful, good, saving, wonderful Father. And we trust You. And so in You, we shall not want. And we thank You that Your goodness and Your mercy are following us every day of our lives. In the strong name of Jesus, amen. Let's be seated.
Thank you, Rochelle and team, for that really positive thought. We have everything we need. We've got it all. In fact, right from the beginning of creation, God made sure that the world and its people have everything they need to sustain life. In the story in Genesis, we see that there was first light, water, and then things began to happen. Through light and water, things can happen, like other kinds of life. Really important things like amoebas and one-celled creatures. We have everything that we need. And God provided it right from the beginning. What I have learned coming out of the pandemic, what we've all learned, I think, is that we had time to take stock of who we are, where we've been, where we're going, and what makes sense to us, what's important. We came out of the pandemic with some lessons learned. And for me, it's a message of hope. God gave us everything we need. Here's a composition. The poetry of it is in haiku, very short syllables, short thoughts, very reduced, but it comes from Scripture. It talks about the very beginnings of things and how life sings in its profundity. Life is always singing and always recreating. Look at the grass. You guys have real grass down here. In Parry Sound, we're still shoveling snow. Well, not quite. The buds are yet to be seen. Yes, always, always change, always coming forward, a message of hope. So we have five sections in this, a prologue which sets up the song of life, and then a song about light, luminous, a song about water, aqueous, a song about one-celled organisms and living things, amorphous, shapeless. And then an epilogue that kind of sums it all up and says, out of chaos comes great things at the hand of God. So the story is to be continued. That's His promise.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made.
Thank you.
Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. The skies were made by God's command. He breathed the word and the stars popped out. He scooped sea into his jug. He put ocean in his keg. Earth creatures, bow before God. World dwellers, down on your knees. Here's why. He spoke and there it was, in place the moment he said so. Then God said, "Let the waters swarm with swarms of living creatures. Let flying creatures fly above the lands across the expanse of the sky." Then God created the large sea creatures, an ever-living creature that crawls, with which the water swarms according to their species. and God saw that it was good. Then God blessed them by saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the water in the seas." Galaxies and this very planet were brought into existence out of watery chaos by God's word. Surely you know, surely you have heard, the Lord is the God who lives forever, who created all the world. He does not become tired or need rest. No one can understand how great his wisdom is. For his is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Oh,
No, they're not settling in for a big, long sermon. We're just going to be joined now by the Oshawa Temple Songsters. And Heather and I have had the delightful pleasure of being with them throughout the weekend, Friday night, and earlier this morning. And we sang together and prayed together and talked about life and about what it means to challenge the world's values and to look in chaos for order and to even thank God for chaos when it happens, because he says be thankful in all things. And as we see, we've got everything. We've got it all. We just have to be willing to see it there and utilize it. By way of setting up this first song, which is called All Things New, I want to point us all to a wonderful scripture, a well-known scripture. It's deep, it's profound, and yet it's atrociously simple. A child can understand it. It's Revelation 21, and those tiny verses in there that are so wonderful and beautiful and simple and yet profound. This is John speaking his vision, and he's talking about the figure of Jesus Christ being on the throne. And the message that he's receiving in this vision is directly from Jesus. So John says, "He who was seated on the throne, Jesus, said, 'I am making everything new.' Then he said, 'Write these down, John. Write them down, for these words are trustworthy and true.' He said to me, 'It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. To him who is thirsty, I will give to drink without cost from the spring of the water of life. And he who overcomes will inherit all this, and I will be his God, and he will be my son.'" The song that we're going to sing, All Things New, is written, the music is written by a contemporary 20th century composer by the name of Elaine Hugenberg. And if you've heard the song, Oh Love That Will Not Let Me Go, have you heard that? Elaine Hugenberg is kind of on the hit parade today with the songs that she's writing. She's gaining a lot of notoriety because her music is beautiful and transparent and really gets at the heart of the text. So she's a heavyweight writer from the 20th century, but the words that you're going to hear come from the 19th century from another heavyweight, Frances Havergal. I was trying to think of the middle name, Ridley. She was very proud, I guess, of her middle name, Ridley, because there was a family member who had been martyred, and that name was Ridley, and it was given to her. So Frances Havergal, Frances Ridley Havergal, has written some of the hymns in our hymn book to, who was on the Lord's side is one of them. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my silver and my gold. Such simple ideas, very practical. And in my reading, I found that Frances herself was a very practical person. She was very measured in her life. She was disciplined in her life. And for that time, she was extremely well-educated and bright, came from a pastor's home, and learned Hebrew, learned Greek, spoke French, spoke German, and lived her life much the way her songs describe a good Christian should, a person with integrity, a simple faith, and yet she spoke openly of her love of God and her salvation. The ideas in her songs are always very plain and simple, like, take my life. Who was on the Lord's side? Who will for him will go? Very measured, not esoteric and dreamy or haiku or anything that you got to think about. But very, very measured and practical thinking. So when you put a heavyweight like Frances Havergal with a heavyweight if you will, musical heavyweight from our own century, Elaine, and you put them together, and you add the weightiness of the text that we've just seen, the text, I'm going to make all things new. All things are become new. It's present tense. Yes, we normally read this with a sense of someday in perfection, things will be as God intended them, and change will stop and will just be the way things were supposed to be ordered. We have that sense about the future. But I believe God is speaking to us today that there is renewal and newness and continuance here while we're on earth. And we can thank God for those good things that He gives us. We can thank Him for the chaos and for the victories. We can thank Him for the light and for the darkness. We thank Him for the chaos, the pain. And so we have in the hands of Havergal a wonderful set of phrases that are like equations. This after that. God gives us this, and we've endured this. God gives us this, even though we've lived through. That's the thought. And you'll see that the music being truly beautifully transparent and lifting the text as it does, it's going to be, an encouragement to us all as we consider the things in our life that we'd like to make new. I'll ask the songsters now to join me, and we're going to mass together for two songs. After this song, we're going to pause for a prayer to capture the resolution that's in the air, capture the sense of longing for newness and for recreation. We're going to capture that in prayer. Melody's going to bring that to us. But now the words of Francis Havergal and the beautiful music of Elaine Hagenberg, All Things New.
Shall we pray? Father, we thank you because you are not only creator, but you are sustainer of all life. But you are also a recreator. You can transform sadness to joy, despair into hope, bring love after loneliness, and eternal life for mortality. Help us to know that even the darkest nights will turn into dawn for the faithful. Keep our focus on you, Alpha and Omega, perpetually present and working Father, who makes all things new. Amen.
Thank you. I don't know about you, but I have been blessed. Yes? Amen? God is wonderful. We're so thankful for music and singing and joy. All of that we have experienced tonight. And all of this takes quite a lot of work, so I just want to take a minute and say thank you to those who are taking billets tonight. Thank you very much. This has started, I think it was Wednesday, with setup and servers and cooks and promotion and sound and live stream. So many people involved. And a very special thank you to Darylyn tonight. And the Oshawa Temple Songsters, yes? Amen. You do bless us. I'm very tempted to join, but you take, okay. You know, we're so blessed with Canada Staff Songsters. It's been amazing. Thank you. Thank you. We know the commitment from, because some of our members, and I think, how do you do all of that? You're at Songsters in your core and Songsters with the Staff Songsters, and I'm going so much practice in music. So I know it brings you joy and God's blessing on you, each one. We are very thankful. Tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock, you're going to be here, right? Our church starts at 10:45 tomorrow. All right, be here 10:30. We'll all be good. It's wonderful. We can't wait to come to church tomorrow and worship God and praise His holy name. Amen. Now, being the good host that Oshawa Temple is, we know some of you, it's almost bedtime, right? Yeah. We have prepared a bedtime snack. Wow, we have cookies and sweets and coffee and tea and hot water. Why not? So you can stay. Please, please stay for fellowship. You need your food before you go home. So we pray God's blessing on each of you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining us. God bless you, everyone.